Welcome to the 3D Sequencer Features and Add-on tutorial. What is it and why is this useful? When we take scene data, including objects, lights, cameras, and also with an animation timeline per scene, when we have all of these, we can put them together and use them in a scene container. Once we have a scene ready, we can now duplicate them and use them as sequencer scene strips inside of the sequencer. But with the 3D sequencer, we can now use a pinned master timeline so that we can have all of our scene strips change the 3D viewport scene contents on the fly and real time before render. This is useful, especially when you need multiple scenes and shots and you need to edit them on the fly while you create your sequence of shots. So the first step of 11 is to activate the add-on. To do this, go into your preferences, go into the Bforartists category, and search for the 3D sequencer and activate. The next step is to load the 3D sequencer workspace. To do this, first go to the workspace tabs, then hit the plus icon to the far right, and go down into the video editing workspace templates group and select the 3D sequencer workspace. When you first load the 3D sequencer workspace, you have a camera view on the left, a 3D view on the right, the sequencer timeline, and the dope sheet. You can also use the properties editor to the bottom right and change it to a scene view outliner using the quick toggle, and from there you can right click or use the scene operators to make a new scene, copy the settings, or create a linked copy or even a full copy and duplicating all of the scene data. After you have loaded the 3D sequencer workspace, you now need to set up the scenes as shots in the sequencer editor. This means you need to prepare the master timeline scene and add and edit the scene strips. To begin, you will need to define which scene is your master scene timeline and which scene will be your shot. With your master scene timeline selected, go into the sequencer timeline, go into the header add menu, into the scene submenu, and add in your additional scenes as scene strips. Now that you have prepared your master scene timeline with scene strips, now you can use the interface, header buttons, and the sequencer panel, and the 3D view panel to pin and set the master scene. Before we can sync, you have to go to the sequencer editor header and then select which scene you would like to pin as the sequencer timeline. And from there, if you want to sync to the 3D view, you also need to define which is your master scene. So go into the View tab, go into the 3D view sync panel, and select the same scene. This will now synchronize which cameras and which shots are displayed between the two views. So now we have the master scene timeline that has been pinned, the master scene defined so that they synchronize with the 3D viewport. Now we can turn on the 3D sync to synchronize and play the master scene timeline. To start synchronizing, we need to go to the sequencer header to the far right and click on the sync button. After we click on the sync button, we will need to click on a particular shot either from the outliner or by toggling into the scene using the header scene menu and toggling the active scene strip. This will enter one of the shots, which will allow us to use the sequencer to change the shots. When we synchronize from the 3D sequencer, we have a number of advanced settings, including keeping the grease pencil settings when we're changing scenes, use bidirectional so that when we're moving the scene timeline, it also moves the dope sheet, or if we move the dope sheet, it also moves the sequencer timeline. We can also use the preview range of your scene strips, and we can also synchronize all of the windows and follow the active playhead. Now that we have the 3D sequencer in sync with the 3D viewport, it comes into the part where we edit the master scene timeline by adjusting scene strips from the sequencer. To start adjusting, we can select a scene, go into the scene header menu, and adjust the timing, which will extend the scene strip. We can also cut a scene and move it to another location, and we can also slip the scene content and move them around. From there, you can edit the scene strips directly from the 3D view by changing the cameras and the assigned scene and settings. In the sequencer sync panel in the 3D view, you can select a shot, you can assign a camera, You can select the camera in the 3D view to manipulate it. You can remove the selection and assign the active camera. And you can also duplicate a scene to create and assign a new one to that particular scene strip. You can also edit your scene timelines using the Scene Strip Overlay widget from directly inside of the dope sheet. When you have the options for the Scene Strip Overlays, you can now use a widget activated, usually by default, to drag the white bar to move a timeline within the sequence. Use the green slider to extend the beginning or extend the end. And from there, retime your strips. Bear in mind, you can only drag to the beginning of the start frame, and this changes only the preview range. So this is where we get to the power of mixing workflows with the 3D sequencer. In some cases, you can use the grease pencil for storyboards. You can block out animation and layout and set up your cameras from there. You can animate your characters. This is handy when you pin an animatic to your timeline and synchronize various scenes as various takes of your animation. And you can use the real-time compositor for post-processing and color balancing before you commit to render. Bear in mind that when you create a scene, the preview of the scene strip is the preview range. If you want to render the entire clip, make sure that you have set your start and end frame to the preview range. In the near future, we hope to add batch rendering to Bforartists soon, but in the meantime, you can also use a .bat script file to render multiple files and multiple scenes from the same command line for Bforartists. To do this, you can set your path, set your file name, and set the scene name as many times as you want from as many files as you need, and render from the command line. So, in summary, to use the 3D sequencer, set up scenes as shots, then pin and set up the master scene, and then synchronize with the 3D view. Edit your timelines either from the dope sheet, from the 3D view, or directly in the sequencer, and then set it up to render. I hope you find this useful. You can download this and use this for free today from www.bforartists.de/download. It's 100% free.